Thanks everyone for joining us. My name is Dave Murphy and I'm the regional manager for 360 Yield Center. So what the 360 rain machine is an application tool for a farmer, and it allows the farmer to apply whatever liquid of their choice on the day that they choose. So we can come in as soon as the day after the planter, and we can stay as long as the day up till harvest and give the grower the ability to apply any liquid, for the most part, any liquid to their field. So in its purest form, it's water only. And probably more than 50% of our machines apply water only. And then we also dose liquid nutrients in a spoon feed scenario over the course of the season based on soil tests, tissue tests, or whatever the farmer's plan is. What's more common in Wisconsin, of course, and very popular with the livestock community is the ability to do manure. So we have four sites that are running hog manure in Illinois and Iowa, and we're diluting hog manure in with a blending skid into a fresh water stream, either from a well or from surface water. In Wisconsin, where we have dairy manure, which is a little easier to handle in terms of solid content, we are still diluting manure usually, but we're diluting it with runoff water like leachate, or with fresh water. We're mixing it in with fresh water because the allowable limits for manure gallons is pretty low in terms of what the capability of the machine is. So as rough numbers, when you look at your chart there on your tech sheet, it carries 3,000 feet of hose, and it's kind of designed around 160 acre approximately. If the field's relatively square, like this field here behind us, this is about 200 total acres, and we're able to water about 180 of it by putting the machine, you know, more so in the center of the field. If you had smaller field sizes, that's fine. We wouldn't have to give you you wouldn't have to buy the full 3,000 feet of hose. You could buy less to reach a smaller field. And then your flow rate in terms of gallons would go up because we have to push the liquid through less amount of hose, meaning we can push more gallons out every hour. So the top flow rate through the machine is around 250 gallon per minute. That's generally low in the world of quote irrigation space. If you're used to pivots or linears, things that nozzle it through the air, they have to make up for that efficiency loss and their really large pipe size. So they are usually running to water 160 acres, really water 133 of 160. By the time you subtract the corners, they're usually running 1,000 to 1,500 gallon per minute. So we're getting by on usually a quarter of the well size. Every hour of operation for the lifetime of the machine is a smaller well pump, a lot lower pressures. And so we're beating it in cost on the operation side of the machine for the longevity. And the upfront cost is substantially less generally because we're getting by with a much smaller well with smaller flow. But because we're not nozzling it and putting it through the air like what a pivot does, pivot uses nozzles to control its flow rate across the arm, meaning the nozzles are much bigger on the outside where it covers much more acreage than on the inside where they're small. Because we're not nozzling it into the air, we don't have that evaporative loss. So basically for the whole month of June, our relative humidities have been below 50%, some days as low as the mid-30s. When you nozzle water droplets into small sizes like that, probably approximately less than 50% of the gallons that you're paying to pump out of the ground are hitting the ground in terms of feeding your crop. Whereas here you'll see with our Y-drop style drops, we're dropping everything in a band. And we've done that for years at 360 Yield Center with original founder of Y-drop, Bandits on your planter for banding nitrogen. So we're all about being more efficient with our nutrients. And banding in nutrients is at least twice as efficient as broadcast because you're only fertilizing where your root zone is. We're doing the same type of practice here that you'll see as the machine kind of comes over the edge. We're getting a lot more value in terms of the amount of gallons that we pump, the amount of nutrient that we apply relative to where it hits the ground and gets absorbed by the corn plant. The machine is totally autonomous and it's being driven by RTK GPS, which means unlike the Garmin in your car that's talking just to satellites that has a few feet of accuracy, this machine is talking to a GPS globe that's fixed on the earth, and it's fixed back up at the dairy farm a couple miles behind you over your shoulders. So that system and the GPS components that come with it are part of the machine. They're part of the whole system because we put a GPS box and a little planter tower on your planter. So then when the farm family plants this field, we capture where that planter ran sub inch relative to that base station that the farmer owns. And then we use that to correct the machine sub inch for the rest of the season. So every year we will capture those planter lines. Our mapping team will create a path map that runs up and down where the planter was, and the machine will drive that with 1 centimeter accuracy for the rest of the season. So one of the first steps to that mapping process is what I have laid out here in front of me. It's a simple GPS puck, and I have this one mounted with a mount that we could put on the gator. So like on Nick's Ranger, we mounted this on the side. After we had the base station powered up, before we planted, we put this unit in the bed of the UTV, and it's got a cellular device, and it's got an FM receiver that talks back to the base station. And we went around and we marked any area that we did not want the machine to water into. So he's got a fairly steep waterway that he didn't want to drive through. We bordered that out. We bordered the whole field. If we had any obstruction like trees, telephone poles, we'd drive a circle around those and mark that out on the map too, so our mapping team can take that into effect. It does not cross over with your other implements. So you'll use your existing planter and harvester guidance and everything else you use now. You'll use that existing for your steering. All we're going to do is ride along and capture those lines. So whether you plant with RTK or you plant blindfolded with markers, we'll be able to drive that machine right up and down those rows. It's not towable. The planetary reduction is so large that nobody makes a disconnectable planetary. So it's not set up to do 30 acres a day and 40 acres 2 miles down there. You're not going to pull this around with your tractor. It's a fixed piece in a field. And if it has to be moved, it'll have to be moved on a low boy trailer or driven. And it can be driven. Its top speed's around 3/4 of a mile an hour, but it does it autonomously. So if you have adjacent fields that we need to move into, or if we wanted to move it across the road to this field, it would take a matter of a few minutes, you know, to get it over here, a few minutes to get it across the road, but it's doing it autonomously. You're not driving it. It's more designed that you put the infrastructure in place and then it kind of lives there. It lives there in that field with the infrastructure. So as far as infrastructure goes, in this case, you can see the different risers. There's a riser behind you in the four yellow bollards. There's another one right on the other side of the road that the machine's coupled to. We'll walk over and see that in a minute. That pipeline is coming from the dairy farm that's 1.5 miles away. So there's a pump located up there by where the base station is, and Nick and the family are pumping leachate water to us today, which is a runoff water. You'll get a small smell from it, but you'll get mostly colored water is pretty well what you'll see kind of coming out of the bottom of the drops. So that's feeding to us through the existing subsurface pipeline. And then we've got, in this example, we've got the machine coupled right to that pipeline riser that's a permanent fixture. So another option that Nick and his crew has is to use a piece of temporary lay flat hose and connect to the riser here. And then we could position that machine anywhere in the field. And we would set the paths off of that. So to reach more acres, you can use temporary hose or lay flat hose from a permanent riser or a permanent well that's on the edge of a field. And you can maximize your acreage of coverage with the 3,000 feet by having the hydrant located relatively close to the center of the field. So if you look at any field or any acreage that you want to cover, if you kind of draw an X between each corner, your most efficient spot for the machine to have its home site is somewhere near that X, wherever would be logical.
So I explained to a few people now already, but basically trying to just spoon feed manure and with the leachate water. And ideally, when I get everything set up here, trying to have two electric pumps and basically dial them into whatever I need based on the weather conditions at the time. When the corn is growing fast and needs the nutrients, putting more manure on. When it's dry out now and plant small, putting more leachate water on, and it's just having a lot of options when just all different options for application.